In this demonstration, we're going to show you how to use Kryon Studio to create an automation with dynamic selectors.
Okay, so basically we will going on this RPA challenge. If we click on submit, you will see that the field actually changes. So if I click one more time, you will now see that it's actually going down, okay, downwards. So basically over here, you can see that in Kryon Studio, we have recording and advanced command portion. I'll just jump straight ahead to do the advanced command because I need to read from Excel first. Okay, so basically on the website, you have to download an Excel. I've downloaded that and I've opened it over here. As you can see, there are actually 7 columns. So I have to actually extract out the data from this Excel and then input it into each field. So after I input it into each field, I'm supposed to submit it. Let's get started on that. So the very first thing that we need to do is to set up a global variable. So we need to actually point to an Excel directory. Okay, so this one is the challenge Excel. Okay, so this will be the directory. Okay, let me see the properties. Okay, so you can actually copy the location. Okay. Okay, and then I'm going to do this. Okay, so now when you go into the Excel, you will notice that there's a worksheet, right? So over here is actually called sheet 1. We'll have to declare that because I'm not going to hard code it in. Okay, so worksheet name.
I see you're giving your variables a meaningful name. That's so important when developing a wizard.
Yep, exactly. And we have to give a meaningful name to the step as well. So this one will be setting up of a global variable. Global variable. Okay. Now, the next thing that we need to do is to insert another advanced command to actually extract the data out from this Excel. Okay, so I'll look for Excel. You can see that we have various Excel advanced commands, but I'm going to just copy out for now. Okay, so you need to use a dollar sign and then select challenge Excel directory. Okay, so worksheet actually refers to the worksheet name. Okay. Okay, so we are going to start from column 1, which is here, and row number 2, which is here, because the first row is actually the header. Okay, so here we'll put 1. Row
we
will be
either put 1 or A for columns, right?
Yes, correct. Mm-hmm. Okay, so output will be output. Okay, so over here you can declare your column delimiter or your row delimiter. For now, I'll be using tab and enter as my delimiter. So I will declare that again at step 1. So I'll just put a dollar sign for now. Okay. I'll just click on OK and I can go back to step 1. Okay, I'm going to declare my tab and enter. So you just need to type tab. Okay, so then for enter, we are using a ASCII value. Okay, you don't have to be too concerned by that. Okay, I'm going to shift this down. And over here, you can see that I actually am going to pull out my data from the Excel. Okay, so let me show you the output. Okay, I can actually print the message on screen. Okay.
This is just for development assistance, right?
Yes, exactly. Okay, just to showcase what's actually pulled out from the Excel. Okay, now let me close this. So if I press do it, you can see that at the back, there is some empty spaces, right? So then we have to remove them, okay? Because there are empty rows, okay? So to remove them, okay, just search for remove. Okay, I'm going to remove the trailing blank spaces at the back. Okay, I'm going to select for both ends, okay? So now, if I were to shift this below and do a print, let's see what happens. Can you see that I've removed the empty spaces?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. So now that I know that I'm able to extract the data, I need to actually loop the data. So before that, we have to give it a meaningful name. So over here, I'm going to say read Excel. Okay.
Now, basically, you could put all the advanced commands on the same step, but you want to keep it nice and clean and differentiate the different tasks that you're doing. This is the reason you're doing it
in two separate steps. All right, so I'm actually naming it in different steps so that I know what exactly is happening over at this particular step and I know where to edit in case we need to debug. So over here, we have step number 3. So you can see here, we have set up the global variable. Here, I'm reading the Excel. So now we are going to loop the data, okay? So to loop the data, I can actually look for the keyword loop, okay? Over here, I can loop the table. So it's actually very intuitive. You know that actually my row delimiter is a enter. So I just need to call my output variable and then add an enter over here. Okay. And I'm going to store my current row in a variable. So I'm going to print current row. Okay. I'm going to show you what is actually printed. Okay. Again, I'm going to use show message. Okay. Just for this demo. So let's see what is our current row. So now let me press do it. You can see that over here at step number 2, I actually extracted out the entire content. Okay. And over here, I'm actually doing a loop. So this is John's name, the first one. Okay, then we have Jane, then we have Albert, Michael, okay. Okay, so you know that we are actually looping the row. Okay, now, when we open up the Excel, okay, you will notice that we have first name, last name, company name, row in company, address, email, phone number. All these columns are actually fixed. Therefore, we can actually use the advanced command array in Kryon, okay, get array data to actually pull them out one by one. So I know that I actually store each row in current row. So I'm going to call current row, okay, and the delimiter is by tab, okay, so I'm going to do that. So because I know that the columns are fixed, I know that the first one is actually first name, okay, so I'm going to name it first name. And I'm going to do the same for the subsequent one. Okay, I'm going to do that 7 times. Okay.
So you're just copy-pasting the advanced command.
Correct. Mm-hmm. And then I just need to get the value, item number 2. So the next one would be last name. Okay. And then we have company name, row in company. So this will be company name. So then here we have to change it to 4, row in company. Okay. Next we have address, email, phone number. Okay. Address. Okay. Email.
And last one.
Yeah, phone number. Okay, so that's the 7th column. Oh, you can see that I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so that's from A to G. Okay, now I'm going to disable this because I don't really need it. If you want, we can actually do a recording and place this all in a particular recorded step, right? Okay, so now to do a recording on Kryon Studio, we have actually have this record and append recording. But if we record, we have to overwrite everything, which is not what we want to do. We want to do append recording, okay? So we are going to click on that. And over here is the web page that I would like to record on. So you can press F11, okay? And then I'm going to click on somewhere near to where I want to detect my object. Okay, I'm going to click finish. So we are actually analyzing the data to actually get the recording. Okay, so now we actually have the recording over here. Okay, I'm going to delete this click. Okay, And then I'm going to remove this check, okay, and increase this to about 10 seconds. Okay, over here, you can actually detect an object to see if you are on the right page, okay? But of course, this is a demo. I'm not going to do that, okay? I'm just going to remove that, and I'm going to copy the advanced command from step number 3, which we have did the looping, mm-hmm. and placed it at the end step of our recorded screen. Okay, now let us go to the advanced command view. Okay, I'm going to just control exit and paste it in here. Okay, so once we go back to the page, we observe that the very first thing that we need to do is to press start, right? And then we need to go into each individual field. So how do we actually input the data into each individual field? We can actually use setHTML. Okay, so it's here, setHTML object value. Okay, I'm going to drag it in. Okay, and then I'm going to select an object. Okay, I'm going to select the email field. Okay, and hover over to narrow your selection downwards. Okay, make sure that it's just the field. Of course, when you do that, you have to anchor an object. So because I want to fill in on an email, I'm going to click on email. And then again, I'm going to narrow down my object. So you will see this, okay? Now, for us to test whether it's on the right field, you can actually put in a value and click on this checkbox, okay, to test the selection. So you will see HTML object value was successfully set. When you go in, you will see this. So if I click submit again, okay, and then I do another test. Can you see there is actually
Yes.
Okay, so that's great. That's what we want. And we are going to use a dollar to coring our variable. Okay, so that's for email. And we will do the same for the rest. Okay, so now we'll do it for phone number. Narrow down your search. Choose an anchor object, which is phone number. Again, narrow down your search.
So when we have dynamic fields, it is important to use the anchor object to make sure no matter where the field is, we are actually placing the information on the right field.
Yes, exactly. Correct. Okay. So now we will call in the phone number. Okay.
And again, we can test it if we want for each field to make sure that we are placing the information in the right field, but we don't have to do it for every field.
Okay, so this one will be last name. So it's a very simple thing.
Mm-hmm.
You just need to click and narrow down your search and then search for the anchor object. Okay.
What will happen if you will not narrow it down?
You actually select the wrong selector. Mm-hmm. So that's why we have to narrow down our search. Okay, just to make sure that it's actually selecting on address. Mm-hmm. Okay. So of course, because this website is a dynamic selector, okay, we need to anchor, but that doesn't mean that we have to anchor for all.
Mm-hmm.
So for this one is phone number. The next one will be, okay, I believe I have not put this one, which is company name. Let me check. Email, phone number, last mm-hmm. name, phone number, company name.
You have phone number twice.
Address. Okay. So to use our Kryon selector, you will also have to have our Chrome extension. Okay, Kryon Chrome extension.
Mm-hmm.
So we have address, now go for company role.
So you can see the Chrome extension icon at the top right and it's already activated. This happens by default when you install the Kryon Studio.
Okay, so we have 7. 1, 2, 3.
Now, the order doesn't really matter.
Yeah, the order doesn't really matter. I just need to make sure there's 7 fields.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes.
Okay, we have that. Okay, now we need to make sure that we can click on the submit button.
Do we also need to click start?
Yes, we do. We will add that in afterwards. Okay, so we'll click on HTML object. So we'll select submit. Okay. Okay, so for this one, there is no anchor object. Why? Because this one is already
unique.
Yes, correct. Okay, so I'm going to click OK. If you want to test it, you can test it as well. So you can see that it got refreshed, and then click again. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to add that here. And then we need to click on Start. Okay.
So we need to click start just once, so you're putting it outside the loop.
Yes, correct. Okay, so now I don't need step number 3 because I've shifted the looping to the step number 4. Okay, so here is fill in web form. Let me check. Okay.
It seems do you have to have the Excel open when you're running it?
No, you have to close it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, because we cannot have it open. Okay, so let us test it one time. Okay. So you can see they actually pull the entire data out. Okay. So this is round 1. Round 2.
How many rows do we have in total?
We have 10 rounds. Yeah. So we need to get the entire thing right, and then you will receive a congratulations message. So we are at round 4 now.
Okay, and to sum up what we've done here, we've split an Excel file and we've used a loop command in order to read different rows of the Excel, and HTML commands to set the information inside the web page itself. And we can see no matter where the field is, the advanced command, the HTML advanced command, interacts with the right field based on the anchor that we've set. And we have another one going on.
Okay, we left 2 more rounds. So now it's round 9.
Email, phone number, last name, company name, address, row, and first name. And now it has a different order of the fields. And we can see the congratulation window when we are completed.